Good day, everyone. I'm Rose Ann Tumaliwan, your presenters for today, and I will be going to discuss how to assign a letter grades and how to compute grades. So first, what to include? So grades assigned to students must include only achievements. It is very important to avoid the temptation to include the effort for less able students because it is difficult to distinguish the ability from achievement and effort are combined in some way. So, grades would mean different things for different individuals. Here in report card, grades are reflected in numbers or numerical quantities or in a letter grade. So, it's also arrived at several data on students' performance are combined. And I know that some of you guys already experienced how to receive a letter grades when you are in a junior high school. There are guidelines how to combine the data, the properly weight each component to create a composite. So the weights used are normally agreed upon by the school officials. How many percent goes for quizzes, a project, or the assignments, class participation, and the periodic test. So the more scientific approach is to use principal components analysis, which is hardly practiced in schools because of the difficulty involved. Okay, so put components on same scale to weight properly. Okay, so first equate ranges or scores, or convert all to T-score or other standard scores. Then I will show you that later. So guys, are you familiar in KPUP or the knowledge, process, understanding, and the product or the performance? The KPUP or the K-POP is the new grading system implemented year 2012-2013. A collective known as level of assessment, which would reflect the different levels of the learning outcomes. So this is based on DepEd Orders number 31-0 of 2012, or the policy guidelines on the implementation of the grade 1 to 12 basic education curriculum, or the BEC, the effective school year 2012-2013. So the objectives of the learning competencies of the KPUP is the first is the K, the knowledge, which is the 15%. It checks the factual information, similar to the usual pen and paper activities like objective types of quizzes and tests. The second is the P, or the process or the skill. That is a 25%. It checks the skill and operations like outlining, expressing, and converting information to other forms. The third is understanding, or the U, 30%. It checks the big concepts, the meaning, the principles through explanations and interpretations. The last one is the P, or the product or the performance, which is 30%. It checks the actual application of learning through projects. So that is the total of 100%. So the learning outcomes, which are defined by the four levels of assessment, are reflected in the teacher's class record and shall be given corresponding percentage weight. So since the knowledge is the most basic of the desired learning outcomes, it is given the lowest percent. The lowest percent weight, while the rest that reflect the deeper learning are given more weight teacher measured. Okay, then after the KPUP's summative test has been administered, and after summing up the result of the student's performance on the various levels of assessment, the numerical values are translated into levels of proficiency. Okay, so take note, the level of proficiency is now what appears in the report cards of the student, the letter grade. On April 1, 2015, the Department of Education has released the new grading system. For public schools, for kindergarten to senior high school, the DepEd Order Number 8, Series 2015, which was signed by the DepEd Secretary Brother Armin A. Luistro, FSC, is entitled the Policy Guidelines on Classroom Assessment for the K-12 Basic Education Program. So, according to the K-12 new grading system, all grades will be based on the way through on the learner's summative assessment. So, here, the minimum grades needed to pass a specific learning area is 60, which is transmuted to 75 in the report card. The lowest mark that can appear on the report card is 60 for quarterly grades and final grades. The teacher will bid goodbye to KPUP, the grading system, as the latest K-12 grading system has fewer components, the written works, the performance tests, and the quarterly assessment. So the nice thing about this grading system is that it is more specific than the previous one, especially on concerns of promotion and retentions of students. So here in the K-12 grading system, which implemented SAI 2015-2016, the written works or the WW makes sure that the students can express skills and contents in written form. The second is the performance tests or the PT. The learners show what they know and can do in diverse ways. So the third is the quarterly assessment or the QA. It measures the students' learning at the end of the quarter. So the learners from grade 1 to grade 12 are graded on written works, performance tests, and quarterly assessment every quarter. So these three are given a specific percentage weight that vary according to the nature of the learning area. And yes, before the pandemic, they used this percentage weight, but because of the new normal, school percentage weight changed. Here in the photo, the quarterly assessment removed the quarterly examinations, will no longer administer this school year. So, the 20% grade weight for a quarterly assessment is equally distributed to written works and performance tests. So, here in Table 1 is the percentage weight for grade 1 to 10 per learning area. And here in Table 2 is the assessment component for senior high school, but I will use the three components of the summative test for my example in computing grades later. In grading period, there is one quarterly assessment, but there should be instances for students to produce the written works and to demonstrate what they know and can do through performance tests. There is no required number of written works and performance tests, but this must be spread out over the quarter and used to assess learners' skills after each unit has been taught. Steps for computing grades. Step 1. Get the total score for each component. So in written works, learner's raw score 18 plus 22 plus 20 is equals to 60, and the highest possible score is 65. The performance test is 12 plus 13 plus 19 is equals to 44, and the possible score is 50. For quarterly assessment, the learner score is 40, and the highest possible score is 50. Step 2. Divide the total raw score by the highest possible score, then multiply the quotient by 100%. So in written works, 60 divided by 65 multiplied by 100% is equals to 92.31%. In performance tasks, 44 divided by 50 multiplied by 100% is equals to 88%. In quarterly assessment, 40 divided by 50 times 100% is equals to 80%. Next, for step 3. Convert percentage scores to weighted scores. So, multiply the percentage score by the weight of the component. So, the weight component for the written works is 30%. In performance tasks is 50%. And quarterly assessment is 20%. So, in written works, 92.31% times 0.30 is equals to 27.70%. In performance tasks, 88% multiplied by 0.50 is equals to 44%. Last, in quarterly assessment, 80% multiplied by 0.20 is equals to 16%. In step 4, add the weighted scores of each component. So the result will be the initial grade. So the answer in the previous step at the 27.70% add by 44% add to 16% and the total is 87.7%. For the step 5, you transmute the initial grade using the transmutation table. So in transmutation table, the 87.7% is equals to 92%. Okay, so the 92% is the final grade that appears in the card. So take note, the MAPE individual grades are given to each area, namely that the music, the arts, the physical education, and the health. So the quarterly grade for MAPE is the average of the quarterly grades in the four areas. So that's how the teachers get our compute grades. And remember that these steps are based on the DepEd Order number 8 series of 2015. How grades are computed at the end of the school year. So this is the example report card, the final grades, and the general average. For how to get the final grade, so first you must add the four quarter grades, the 80 add by 89, add to 86, and add to 84, and that is the sum is 339. And 339 divided by 4. And the quotient is 84.75 or 85. So the final grade is 85. For the general average, you get the sum of the final grades of all learning areas. So 85 add to 90 add to 83. Add to 86, add to 91, add to 90, 81, 85, and the sum is 691 divided by 8. So the quotient is 86.375 or 86. And remember that the final grade in each learning area and the general average are reported as whole numbers. So thank you very much. I hope that you learned something from me today. And God bless everyone.